So, should you learn Java? Absolutely. What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Amigoscode. In this video, I want to discuss with you why you should learn Java in 2023. Java is a programming language that has been around since 1995, and it was initially developed by James Gosling at Sun Microservices. And then since 95, it has received lots of upgrades and new features to the language. And in 2009, it was acquired by Oracle. Java comes in two flavors. You've got the OpenJDK as well as Oracle JDK. And the difference really is that the OpenJDK is open source, and also Java has bug fixes and new upgrades to the language every 6 months. I know there's a lot of people that say, you know what, Java is dying and you shouldn't really use Java, but they never give you like a concrete answer why you shouldn't really use Java or why Java is rubbish. And in fact, all of these tech giants, Google, Meta, Microsoft, Twitter, and a bunch of other tech giants are using Java to power their critical systems and open source projects. In fact, if you go on GitHub, you can see a bunch of active open source projects which are still written in Java. And if you look into the surveys that was performed by Stack Overflow across the world, you can see that the programming and script and markup languages, right here, Java sits somewhere, I think it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh my gosh, I can't count. But Java is number 6 on this list. And if we look into professional developers, still on the same position. And people that are learning how to code, it's also, oh, actually, it's number 4 in here. And if you look at this website, which is an index created by analyzing how often language tutorials are searched on Google, and right here Java is number 2. Now obviously here I don't know which website is right or which one is wrong, and maybe it might be, you know, incorrect slightly, but you can see that Java is a language which is still worth learning. It's a language that, you know, it's taught at boot camps, universities, and it's a language that as a beginner I feel like you should learn. Why? Java is a language that teaches you a bunch of fundamentals that other programming languages did look at Java and say, wow, do you know what? Java has so many syntax and so many things, so many keywords. Let's just simplify all of them. Now, the good thing is if you learn Java, for example, and you were to learn JavaScript or Python, then those languages would be a piece of cake. Trust me, it would be a piece of cake. Now, if you reverse, so if you learn Python, for example, or you learn JavaScript, for example, and then try and move to Java, it's going to be really difficult. I can guarantee you. The reason why I recommend Java is for the long run. So if you learn Java, you know, it's easy for you to pick up GoLand, JavaScript, Python, C Sharp, which is, you know, an awesome language. But if you look at it, it's like almost the same as Java. And Java is a foundation to many other languages. And there are times where you see other languages which have, you know, really nice syntax and they've got new features. But I can tell you that Java, it will catch up eventually because, you know, every 6 months there's a new release and there's been improvement on the language. So learn Java and the rest of programming languages will be so easy to grasp. And remember, a language is just a tool to solve a problem. People say, oh, I hate Java because of this, I hate this language because of this. Don't be one of them. Just be a guy or a girl that will just look at the language and say, you know what, I can kind of work with any language because a language is just a tool to solve the job. Now, Java might be a good solution for one particular problem, whereas it might be a crap solution for another problem. So pick the right language for the right job. The other thing which is really nice about Java is that it's an object-oriented programming language, and that means that you kind of create a bunch of classes and you create objects and connect them to each other. So for example, you might have a class called person, another class called car, another class called house, for example, and then you create objects and then you connect these objects together. So this makes it super easy to reason about your application, and you can create well-structured, large-scaled applications. So this is one of the reasons why enterprise companies use Java because it's an object-oriented programming language. Then moving on to the community around Java, because Java has been around for so many years, there's a large active community of developers. With that, you've got great tooling around. So if you look at the frameworks, so Spring Boot, Quarkus, and other libraries that, you know, companies such as Google, they're behind it. There's plenty of tools and frameworks available to you in order for you to build your next big application. So instead of you having to, you know, write things from scratch, you've got frameworks already ready there for you so that you can build applications super fast. So the documentation as well behind the libraries and frameworks around Java, I have to say they are pretty good, like literally pretty good. Yeah, so this is all due to the open source community. So Java is a programming language which powers many applications in production. Like, you know, people say, oh, you know, you should switch from Java to Kotlin, for example, or from Java to GoLand. But it's not as easy as you might think, because these companies, they are making millions, right? And for you to replace a critical system, it's not a one night or 2 days. It's not as simple as you might think. So there are tons of companies out there still looking for Java developers. And let's just face it, there's lots of Java developers, which is a good thing. So one, if companies are starting a new product or there's a startup that are looking to hire, for example, it's much easier for them to pick Java because of the amount of developers out there. And for example, if they were to, let's say, go with Golang, for example, right? So how many people out there, you can call them like an expert in Golang? You know, the numbers are very few, right? So the tooling, the support, the libraries, the framework around Java makes it a perfect choice for many companies. And the last point that I want to talk to you about is building microservices. So with Java, you can, you know, build enterprise applications, you can build mobile applications, which I wouldn't recommend you to do so. Also Internet of Things, cloud native applications. But Java is a language which is really good for the backend and specifically microservices. So if you're building, whether it's a standalone backend or a monolithic application, Java is a great choice, but also microservices, which many companies have adopted, and Java is a great fit, again, because of all the tooling and libraries and frameworks that are around the Java ecosystem. So, should you learn Java? Absolutely yes. And do me a favor, remember that don't stick with just one language. So I always say this, because a language is just a tool. Yes, you can have a preferred language, but just remember that if you have to pick a different language, then you will be able to do, right? Because it's just a tool to solve a problem. Let me know whether you agree or disagree. Literally comment down below and let me know what you want to see next. Smash the like button. And I'll catch you on the next one. Assalamu alaikum.